It's both a gift and a curse, the role of supporting actor. Come on too strong and over the top and you detract from the main character's story, looking like an attention seeker. But play it too quietly, however, and you're forgotten, left by the wayside by more interesting performances. Over the years, there have been a few who've managed the former, but without the implied, attached attention seeking. Despite more important things going on around them, these actors deserve celebrating for making themselves the most memorable thing over the course of their films. So let's look at some. I'm Ben from Whatculture, and here are 10 supporting film characters that completely stole the spotlight. Number 10, Sergeant Dignam, Mark Wahlberg, The Departed. Martin Scorsese's dark, action-packed thriller tracks the turbulent lives of double agents Matt Damon and Leonardo DiCaprio as they try and bring down Jack Nicholson's irresistibly brilliant crime lord. It's a gritty and tense affair set in the violent streets of Boston, packed with impressive turns from Alec Baldwin, Martin Sheen, and Ray Winston. However, none of these performances come close to the surprising efforts of Mark Wahlberg, playing loudmouth detective Sergeant Dignam. Channeling his Boston roots, Wahlberg is snarling and scathing, rude and volatile as DiCaprio and Damon's immediate boss, who is the kind of character you can't help but love. Number 9. Agent Smith, Hugo Weaving, The Matrix Trilogy. The brilliance of the first Matrix film revolved almost entirely around the superbly sinister villain, who sought to end his human foes once and for all with a bitter efficiency. With Keanu Reeves not exactly bringing too much in the way of acting chops to the table, Weaving acts him off screen with a wonderfully measured performance, blending robot-like tendencies with a bitter and terrifying hatred for those that oppose him. As a machine man thing, Smith is truly electrifying to watch as he calmly and coolly threatens, fights, and works his way towards winning the war against the humans. Number 8. Deputy Marshal Sam Gerard, Tommy Lee Jones, The Fugitive. The classic chase movie starring Harrison Ford boasts an absolutely brilliant performance from Jones, who dominates the screen and is totally captivating whenever he's on it. Gerard is a no-holds-barred, dedicated, and thorough police officer who will stop at nothing to catch the wrongly accused Richard Kimball. Though his fellow cops are constantly convinced that Kimball is either dead or out of reach, Gerard ruthlessly sticks to his guns and is absolutely cool as he does it. Number 7. Jeffrey Goines, Brad Pitt, 12 Monkeys. Terry Gilliam's bizarre time travel movie chronicling a desperate and unhinged Bruce Willis aims to find out the cause of a virus that's wiped out the majority of the world's population in the future. Brad Pitt, who has excelled when playing more offbeat roles throughout his career, plays an inmate at a mental hospital Cole is submitted to at the beginning of the film. From his very introduction, Goines is wild, mad, but more human and realistic than his fellow inmates, rattling off a thought-provoking rant within his first few moments on screen and continuing the intensity and wild-eyed mania throughout his story. Number 6. Aaron Stampler, Edward Norton, Primal Fear. This sweeping, twisting courtroom drama was devilishly surprising and tense throughout, but the suspense and entertainment were provided almost entirely by Norton's character Stampler. He's utterly chilling, with a problematic and well-worked backstory providing the real meat in the story. His stuttering delivery, intense stare, and obvious psychological torment make him the clear talking point of the film, and it's hard to see it as being nearly as watchable without him. Number 5. Tommy DeVito, Joe Pesci, Goodfellas. Goodfellas tells the story of low-level mobsters in New York, with Pesci playing the violent and fully psychotic Tommy DeVito in an absolutely spellbinding performance. DeVito is completely unpredictable and, as a result, terrifying to watch because you never know when the violence is going to come. Inevitably, it does, and the conviction of Pesci's acting truly keeps your focus. Number 4. Anton Chigurh, Javier Bardem, No Country for Old Men. Shiver-inducing in his execution, relentless in his tracking, and remorseless in his actions, Chigurh is one of the great movie psychopaths. He seems almost supernatural in the way he stalks the desolate and violent ravaged landscapes of the Coen brothers' thriller. While Josh Brolin and Tommy Lee Jones are also fantastic, it's Bardem's character that shocks you, combining lopsided grins with a freakish haircut as he kills mercilessly. Telling his story almost entirely with facial expressions, Chigurh is haunting and bewitching, as so many of the Coens' darker characters have been, and totally steals the film, proving hellishly memorable well after the film's conclusion. Number 3. Darth Vader, James Earl Jones and David Prowse, Star Wars Episodes 4-6. Darth Vader is a powerhouse, an evil yet complex behemoth trained in the ways of the Force. He's imposing, impressive, terrifying, and awe-inspiring as he looms over the galaxy, by far the most interesting thing in Lucas's world. As a result, he steals the spotlight in every film. Like all the best villains, there is a heart lurking beneath the surface, one that longs for his son and wonders if his place beneath the Emperor is truly what's for the best. But on the outside, he is a cold, metal beast, capable of ending a man's life with a casual raise of the hand. Number 2. Dickie Eklund, Christian Bale, The Fighter. Bale picked up the Best Supporting Actor gong at the Oscars for his performance, and rightly so. He had plenty to dig into for Dickie, who was a complex, disturbing, and haunted character who wants his brother to succeed for partially selfish reasons. Bale performs the role with extreme authenticity and strength, somehow winning us over despite his character's unreliability in a typically inspiring rags-to-riches tale. Number 1. The Joker, Heath Ledger, The Dark Knight. Christian Bale's conflicted, brooding, and dark Batman is superb. Gary Oldman's honest and likable officer is fantastic. Morgan Freeman is wonderful. Aaron Eckhart is also brilliant. But the film belongs to Ledger from the moment the Joker first pulls off his mask. Constantly dancing on the precipice of madness, yet calculated and convicted, he's complex, corrupted, enchanting, and you cannot take your eyes off him throughout. Each scene peels another layer off one of the most devilishly brilliant characters of all time, unfolding the disturbed psyche of a cadaverous and unhinged villain, smirking and giggling his way through Gotham's collapse, laughing at his opposition and uncaring about the possibility of his own death. The Oscar was a given, and justifiably, Ledger will live forever in this performance, bringing a wonderfully well-written character to life in a way so few of us could ever begin to imagine, and even fewer could have predicted when his casting was first announced. And that's our list. Make sure you subscribe to the Whatculture YouTube channel for more lists like this, and don't forget to visit whatculture.com for daily news and articles. I'm Ben from Whatculture, and thanks for watching.